Hey, what's going on, guys? Thomas here. Wanted to come to you on a Monday morning right before lunch with a little bit of a training lesson. And this lesson is really for the owners and managers in your organizations. I want to talk to you about a book that I just read a few months ago. It was The E-Myth Revisited. So it was the second version of E-Myth. Really good little short read. There was something in that book that really jumped off the page that I want to share with all of you today. So, three words. Number one, innovation. You know, sometimes we think of people that are innovative as people that have great ideas. What he does in the book is he says, you know, great ideas are great, but they're not great unless you do something. So, innovation isn't just a great idea, but it's the application of that idea. It's doing something different, doing something better. Innovation. Quantification. Quantification is all about measuring that new thing that you're doing to see, are you getting the right results? Are you headed in the right direction? Are you growing sales? Are you growing profits? Are you booking more calls? So innovation, quantification. And then the last one was orchestration. Orchestration is now having the discipline to do what you know you need to do based on the quantification, the results proved it out, consistently. Do that thing more consistently to drive growth and drive sales and drive profit. So let's go back to innovation. Now in the book, the analogy he uses is two salespeople in a retail store. The guy that writes the book is obviously retail-minded, and so he used a retail example, but it's a good example. So he's got two sales associates at this retail facility. A customer walks in. Let's say associate number one asks a scripted question like, how can I help you? Well, we know that when someone is in a sales role, whether it's retail, cars, doesn't matter, when they ask, how can I help you? Most of us respond with a triggered response, just looking. One of their associates though, that's the question he's gonna continue to ask. How can I help you today, right? The other associate, they said, we want you to ask a different question. Ask them, is this your first time here or are you a returning guest? Now, here's what they found. They had two different associates asking two different questions. And what they found was, by the way, this is quantification, right? They were tracking and measuring the results over a two-week period of these two associates. One asking, how can I help you? One asking, is this your first time here or are you a return guest? The person that was asking, you're probably already kind of catching on to what's happening here. You're probably smelling what I'm cooking, right? The person that was asking, is this your first time here or are you a returning guest? That person's sales were over 16% higher than the other person's sales asking, how can I help you? He's getting a triggered response. The other guy was creating a conversation because the client would say, well, no, this is my first time here, to which the associate would respond, that's fantastic, thanks for coming. By the way, we've got some great specials for first-time customers today. If they said, no, I'm a returning client, oh, thank you so much for your loyalty. Listen, we've got some great deals for our loyal long-term clients. So they created a conversation versus a triggered response. So they quantified it over 2 weeks and found out the guy asking, is this your first time here or are you a returning client, was getting better results, 16% increase in sales. Now, they quantified it. Now what they did is they orchestration. Every team member had to go through training on how to ask that leading and logical question to stimulate some conversation with the client. So you've got the innovation of doing something differently. You've got the quantification of tracking and measuring it to see if you're getting the right result, or maybe you're not, right? Either way, you want to know. So you have to track and measure it through quantification. And then the orchestration is just doing that thing, whatever it was, more consistently. So I want you to think about your business, and I want you to think about the strengths and the weaknesses in your business, and think about, where could I be a bit more innovative? And it's not just ideas, it's What am I going to do differently? And then I want you to think, I've got to be able to quantify this thing. I want to make sure it's getting me the result that I want, the result that I need in my business. And if it's not, back to the drawing board on the innovation, right? So innovation is doing things differently. Now we got quantification, which is quantify, track and measure, and make sure we're getting the right results. And then this is key, orchestration. That means training. That means rolling that communication change out to your team. Or maybe it's a diagnostic process. Maybe it's communicating shape. Maybe it's a financial issue in your company. Maybe it's marketing. Maybe it's recruiting and hiring. Whatever that process is for you, I want you thinking innovation. What am I going to do differently to get the results I want? Quantification. Making sure you're tracking and measuring to make sure you're getting the results that you need and want from that innovation. And orchestration, are you doing it more consistently and producing the results you want? It's a great book, great read. That just jumped off the page at me. Innovation, quantification, and orchestration. This works for your business in all areas of your business. Just got to get started today thinking, what can I do different? What can I do better in my business? Track it, measure it, making sure you're getting the right results, and then do those things more consistently and watch your business grow. Hope this helped. Hope it triggered some thought. Can't wait to hear some of what you've come up with. We'll talk to you soon.